Good morning. How we doing? It's Monday morning, April 10th, and this is actually the first thing I'm filming since Friday, since I was sick the entire weekend. I literally didn't do a single thing besides the amount of TV and movies I watched. It's kind of sickening, to be honest with you. I literally did nothing cool this weekend to film. I did maybe like an hour or 2 hours of work from Friday until Sunday. But it's Monday morning, we're feeling way better, and we're ready to... Ooh, this cop is tailing me. I'll put this on video if I get pulled over. Nah, I'm a flee from the scene if I get pulled over. You guys will have a first glance look at OJ. Oh no, he turned off. So we're ready to take the week on. Right now, I'm going to the gym, but not my old gym. Thank God I'm done with New York Sports Club. I hate that place. I'm back to Gold's Gym now that I'm at home permanently. I switched over first because the building I was working in New York had a New York Sports Club in it. So I was basically using it for its convenience. And I switched out of Gold's Gym, which is a couple towns over from me. And now I'm going back to that gym. I'm honestly super excited to get back there. So I'm going to work out now. And then it's beautiful out. It's supposed to hit like 70 degrees today. So I'm going to try to find... there's a place in the town over from me that I could actually work outside. It's like a little coffee shop that has tables set up outside. So this week it's supposed to be like 70, 80 degrees. I'm like, bet I need to be outside the entire time.
And it goes a little something like this.
So we're just getting bike from the gym. This is hard to do with all the shit in my hands. I picked up a picture frame, or a poster frame, I should say. So I ordered these posters like a month and a half ago, 2 months ago, and I literally haven't hung them up in my room. Little decoration, there's three of them. I only got one poster because the other ones aren't gonna fit in the ones I had at the store. I need a little inspiration in my room because my room is literally, this was my mom's room before, that's why it's green. I should probably repaint it, but I have nothing hanging on the walls. So I wanna get some poster action in here, get a little, you know, get some vibes going in there. Picked up a coffee, because the Rangers won, $1 coffees from Dunkin'. Also had something shipped to me from Amazon. This is like a new shoe cleaner. So I'm actually gonna do a video of reviewing the product and cleaning my shoes, probably these Nikes. A pair of my Ultra Boosts, and I'll let you guys, I mean, that'll probably be the next video, or it's already probably out on my channel if you're watching this video. So if you're looking for like a good shoe cleaner, definitely go check that out. Also, this was recommended to me by a good friend of mine who runs his own Instagram account all about shoes. He's a big sneakerhead. So he pulls some dope pictures of any new shoes that come out, like Nikes, Jordans, Adidas, all that shit. So go check him out on Instagram. I'll link his thing right here. So go follow him. Tell him Big Dog sent you. Gonna settle down, try to fit one of these posters in there. It's probably not gonna work because I had no idea like what the sizes were supposed to be. So I'm gonna end up probably have wasted $30 on that picture frame. I ordered two more off Amazon for the smaller fitting ones because they didn't have the right sizing. And I'm gonna go bring my laptop over to the coffee place I was explaining to you about earlier in the clip and do some work.
I got my city doing front flips.
Poster number one. Wow, I'm shocked this actually worked. Oh man, I love Chance the Rapper. I'm not like one of those groupies that just jumped on the bandwagon. He's been my man for like years now. I saw him last summer in concert. I swear I got this before like the Grammys and won all those awards and shit. This has been sitting on my table for forever. That's poster number one. I'm excited. That's a pretty dope poster. And if any of you guys are looking for like cool posters for your room or your apartment or anything, there's a site called nakedloft.co and they have like all like cool kind of like creative pop culture outside of the box kind of drawings and paintings. And these are actually all like hand printed. It's a weird material. It's different than normal posters. So it's like handmade. I remember when they got them shipped, it was like from like China or some weird country that was like I wasn't expecting it to come from. Not that China's weird or anything like that. No discrimination here. But yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff on that site, so go check that out if you're interested in getting some artwork. They're pretty, I think those posters were like $20 or $25, so not bad. So I made a little proton smoothie shake. It's basically just two scoops of protein, 5 grams of creatine every day, bulking or cutting, shidomata, raw spinach. Don't knock until you try it, recipe video right there. It's really fucking good, I swear. Pack of Splenda for you hippie motherfudgers. And some frozen berries, which are like blackberries, blueberries, raspberries, I think. It was just like from Trader Joe's, so I put a serving of that in. Usually call this the Hulk juice because it comes out pretty green, but it's kind of purpley. So we're gonna call it the Ivan Ooze juice today. I know that shit's disgusting, but it tastes really good. The whole thing is like 370 calories and like 65 grams of protein, so. Pretty good. Try it out. If you do, let me know in the comments below. Ow. If you don't like it, money back guarantee from me. Not only is that the feeling when your mom makes pizza rolls, but when you get show tax returns. We made it, fam. About to go blow it all on some strippers. I'm just kidding. I'm gonna use it sensibly. Put it towards the business. Fast forward, Tuesday morning. Good morning, how y'all doing? It's around 8:15, April 11th. I've been up for a couple of hours. Yesterday, something I didn't share yesterday. I got an email from the CEO of the company called fantasyjocks.com. If you watch any of my older videos, fantasy football related, there where we get our draft boards for the live draft, like the fantasy belt that we have for our league and all that kind of stuff. They sell those products. And I used to work with them when I first started freelancing, when I was blogging and stuff for fantasy websites. Said he watched my video starting the business. Congratulations, all that stuff. And then he was like, you're interested in Facebook advertising. Let's get on the phone this week. So I'm super pumped up about that because they would definitely be an ideal client of mine to work with long term for sure. And what I'm doing now is basically, it's Tuesday now. I'm getting on the call with him 12 o'clock. No, it's 12 p.m. Pacific. They're in California. So 3 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow. So on Wednesday, I'm getting on the call with him. And before I get on the initial call, I want to do a lot of, I want to do research on, and this is something I would do before any initial call that I would do with a client. And what kind of research? I'm not talking about like what I talked about last week in the actual Facebook platform, but you know, the first things I would do would be go to their website, go to their social media, Instagram, Facebook, things like that, and get a feel for their business and their products and things like that. So this is what their website looks like, fantasyjocks.com. And like I said, they sell like the fantasy belts, they sell rings, trophies for your league, all this kind of stuff. So it's an e-commerce website. Depending on what kind of campaign you do, what kind of clients you're working with, you know, in my experience, when you're working with small businesses or local businesses, you can be working with anything from an e-commerce site that sells products online to physical trainers, to contractors, to gyms, to yoga studios, you know, to service companies. So the product that you're going to be advertising with on Facebook is going to be so different from client to client. So you have to get to know what you're really into and know what you're getting yourself into. So first thing I would look at, you know, looking at the website, I want to get a feel for about how many products they have. When you're doing an e-commerce website, you know, you have to figure out what platform they're selling through. And the most popular platform for most e-commerce websites called Shopify. And it's basically just like a platform that enables you to, it integrates with your website and it enables you to sell your products online. So that's something that Facebook works pretty well with in terms of the pixels. That won't be too difficult. And then I wanna look at their Instagram, see how many followers they have, see how many Facebook fans they have on their page, because when you're running these campaigns, right, you gotta look at your cold audience and you gotta look at your warm audience, right? And your cold audience is basically people that they have no idea who your brand is, they have no idea what your products are, they've never heard of you. Your warm audience is the people that have engaged with you, visited your website, they're a fan of your page, they might be on your email list, they might have subscribed already or bought one of your products, right? So it's much easier to sell to, it's much easier to convert people who are in the warm audience who have already showed interest in your brand and they're aware of your brand, right? So you want to run different campaigns depending on who you're targeting in the audience. Now, what's also interesting that I found, I already knew this obviously, but it's ironic and it's funny. They have a blog section on their site, which I actually ran, if you could see my name on there. Which I wrote like two or three summers ago, ironically, and I think that it would be a great idea to recycle these articles and then start putting them through Facebook advertising when the summer rolls around to get engagement to these cold audiences, to get them to know more about the brand. Because as the fantasy football industry grows, you know, these kind of articles will get much more popular. And these are articles like the best sites to do your draft on, the best Twitter accounts to follow for fantasy football, celebrities that play fantasy football, the best punishments for fantasy football, how to determine your draft order. These are all articles I wrote a couple years back. But these are things that would get high engagement on Facebook, especially if you're targeting to the right audience of fantasy football players. So these are just things you want to go into. And then off those articles, people who engage, then you can create your warm audience based off those. Because, you know, it's a mix of branding and then it's a mix of direct sales. So it's a funnel that you have to work through in marketing. It's not just you put your picture of your product on and everyone wants to buy it. You know, you have to build a relationship with the customer before you can. You gotta go on a couple dates before you can close the deal. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm doing now. Whenever you want to go into a call, you got to go in with ideas. I want to go in there and just have him know that I know what I'm talking about, that I've done work, I'm interested in their company, I'm interested in doing this for them. So I want to have a lot of ideas off the rip, and that's what I'm doing now. And then we going back to Gold's Gym for, yesterday I did a lower body workout, today I'm going to do an upper body workout. So that's kind of my split right now. Well, this is actually my legit split, if anyone happens to care. Hit legs twice a week, Monday, Friday. Upper body twice a week, Tuesday, Saturday, a HIIT session on Wednesdays, and then just two regular cardio sessions, which I'll just walk on the treadmill, or if I feel like going for a run or something.
Right now! Woo! 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 100,000 views for less than $1,000.
Like, I think the other untapped market,
we then turn it into what it needs to turn into. Like, I have a couple guys.
That's probably like a bigger play in the long run, honestly, too, that side of your business. And I think,
later, brother.
Alright, thanks, man.
Alright, so it's Wednesday morning. That's about 11:30. So that was the owner of the, I don't even want to say wedding services anymore, because he created his own media/video entertainment company. And that was the guy that went down to Florida to shoot the mansion, the videos of the mansion. And insanely, he said, while he was down there shooting with the real estate agent guy, this is a true story. This is what he just told me. I wouldn't believe it if he didn't tell me. He said he wouldn't believe it if he wasn't there to see it happen. A dude was on his yacht or his boat or something, pulled up to the house. He knew it was for sale. And he said he offered, the house was selling for $19.5 million. He offered the real estate agent $17 million in cash for the house right there on the spot. He didn't bring the cash with him, obviously, but he made the offer on the spot. They accepted the offer upon inspection or some shit, so we didn't actually have to go ahead with a campaign selling the house, which, to be honest with you, I'm not, like, disappointed about it, because that's not really, well, it wouldn't be really my avenue, because I'd really be working more with the real estate agent than the actual the entertainment company. I don't know, it's a crazy fucking story. This guy was so supposedly like top 30 Forbes list. He said his girlfriend thought the house looked nice, so we wanted to throw $17 million at it. Shit must be nice. Either way, it's 11:30, he's got off the call with them, so I'm going to meet up with him on Friday. We're going to actually sit down physically together to try to get things in motion and really get the campaign kicking off. I have the call with Fantasy Jocks in 3.5 hours, so I'm doing a little more research before I get onto the call, and then I'm going to hit up the barbershop today to see if I can get in there tomorrow. So we have a busy next couple of days to get things really, really, really rolling. And I know it's been a couple weeks and I haven't really started on anything big, but I think it's about the time that it starts really kicking off. And I'm kind of nervous. I'm pretty scared, I'll be honest with you, to really get these things in motion, because, you know, once it starts, it doesn't stop. It's full circle and just becomes your life, right? So I'm nervous to get into it, but I'm definitely excited, because, like, when I'm focused, when I'm zoned in, is when I do my best work, and I feel like this is where it's coming down to. So I'm gonna go downstairs and hit the treadmill for a little bit, try to clear my head, try to get it right before I dig in for the rest of the day to work. I'm gonna try to do a HIIT workout, sprints. The thing about this treadmill that sucks is, one, you can't do incline. You can't, like, press it to go incline. You actually literally physically have to go in the back, lift up these two fucking leg things. So it goes incline, so it doesn't count anything on the machine. And two, it only goes up to 10 speed, which is definitely not, like, my sprinting speed. But we'll start there and see how it goes. And the treadmill's, like, only, like, this big, so I'm probably going to fall off. So I'm not even going to videotape it, because I don't want that shit on camera. All right, 2:59, Wednesday. About to hop on this call with the Fantasy Jocks. Let's get it. My heart's kind of racing a little bit. You ever, like, walk into a big meeting when you're about to present or something? I know it's, like, so small and so minuscule, but I'm a little nervous.
Hi, you've reached the voicemail balcony. I'm unavailable to take your call at the moment, if you would.
I thought you'd be back. He'd be back. Dustin, what's going on, man?
I would have, you know, started this 10 years ago, because it's just like, damn, you know, like, it sneaks up on you fast. So you got an early start, and I think it's definitely a good move. And I think that by kind of niching down specifically into the Facebook advertising like you're doing is really a smart thing. I'd like to kind of take off my plate, and I think that you'd be the perfect fit for it. And
what are you thinking in terms of, like, a timeline?
Our season basically kicks off as soon as the NFL draft happens. You know, like, you know, at the end of this month, as soon as that concludes, then people start emailing, kind of asking about, hey, when do you have the draft get ready and all that.
I'm all in with you if you want to give this a go, for sure. I think we'd fit together really, really well.
Together, like a marketing proposal of some services you can do and all that, and we'll kind of take it from there.
You have no idea how how excited I was when I got that email from you, to be honest. Take care, Dustin. I'll talk to you soon.
Right,
peace, brother. I already know this is going to be an absolutely killer client, killer campaign. This is going to set me off in the right direction. I don't really know what else to say. I'm excited. I'm super pumped up right now, and I'm ready to go. So he wants me to get him over kind of a proposal of services. Now, this is not something I would normally do with other clients, but since it's in the fantasy football industry, you know, this is something I'm super knowledgeable about. Not about winning my leagues, I know. Don't worry, E-Town, get down, people. But just the industry as a whole, like what sites people that really care about, you know, their leagues look into. Just a ton of different stuff that I know about the industry just from like really getting into it the last 3-4 years or so. And I'm going to have, I guess, a proposal in terms of what I can offer them, pricing, all these kind of things. So this is going to be a very busy weekend for me. This is a lot of stuff I'm going to have to hammer down because this is things that I really haven't gone over yet with clients. So this is going to be like my first time getting it over to someone and just like kind of I set the tone moving forward for how I'm going to operate. So it's Wednesday night. I told him I'd get it to him by like Monday. So I have basically all weekend to work on it. Oh man, I'm pumped up. Let's go. We're back in the exact same spot. This is a different shirt, by the way. I was wearing gray in the last clip. I promise. Oh yeah, I got my new chance poster up there. I 100% did that wrong. There's 100% chance that the nail I put into the wall is going through my house right now and is on the other side of the house if you went outside. But I digress. What am I working on right now? It's April 13th, about 11:30 a.m. I've been up forever. Couldn't really sleep for some reason. And right now I'm working on a couple things. One, I filmed the mock draft round 3 episode, so I'm editing that up, which will get out today on Thursday. And then I'm working on my proposal pricing kind of thing that I need to get over to Fantasy Jocks and just I need to have for future references for future clients and shit like that. I'm doing a bunch of shit that I just don't know how to do. I've never done before, but that's how you learn, right? Like, I don't know. I was thinking like literally the only way to learn is by doing something, by taking action and probably fucking it up and learning from that fuck up, right? Think about anything you're good at, right? Think about whether it's a sport, whether it's like Microsoft Excel, whatever it is in the world, you don't get good at it by listening to a podcast about it. You don't get good at it by thinking about it, by any of that shit. You can learn information about it, but the only way you actually learn and get better at something is by doing it and putting it into action and doing it over and over and over and over again until it becomes repetition or until, you know, you mess up and then next time you do it, your mind's like, yo, you messed up doing it last time like this, so let's try a different path to get there. I saw a great quote the other day. An expert is a person who has made all the mistakes that can be made in a very narrow field. And it makes sense. Imagine going along, you know, a fork in the road. Like, you pick your path, you pick whatever you want to do. You're going along the path and you get a fork in the road. You can go left or right. Decide to go left the first time, right? Dead end. Boom. So next time you try it, you go right and you just keep learning. And that's what you do with anything in life, right? You have to, if you want to get somewhere, you want to learn something, you got to take action on whatever it may be. So it's such a cliche, but people are like, you either win or you learn. And that's so fucking true in life. Because if you do something right, great, you did it right, and then you can keep going. But if you lose, you just learn from that, and then you're able to move forward with it and learn from your mistakes. You don't actually lose anything because, you know, unless you literally died on that loss, then you keep going, you know? Anyway, so I got proposal, editing. Listened to a great podcast this morning. My boy Gary Vaynerchuk was on with Pat McAfee and the Barstool crew. So definitely Google that if you're looking for a new podcast. That shit was great. Barbershop updates. I'm going in for a cut on Thursday. Oh, no, on Saturday. I'm sorry. So I'm going to sit down with the owner then. I'm going to walk in there and he's going to be like, what you want? I'm going to be like, put a Facebook symbol on my head. He's going to be like, say no more, fam. And then we get the campaign kicking. Nah, so I'm going to see him Saturday. Tomorrow I'm going with the entertainment guy. We're going to go sit down with another realtor for like a couple hours, whatever. He's going to be busy a couple of days. Over this weekend. So I think this is the last clip unless something else comes up today. But for now, that will wrap up week 4 of me starting my business. So we're almost a month in now. And it's going slowly, but definitely going surely. And if you've been enjoying these, if you've been staying up to date, give that thumbs up. Comment something down below. I don't really care what you say, to be honest with you. I just want to talk to some people. I'm lonely here, man. We got dress down day at the office today. It doesn't get too much better than that. Anyways, that's going to wrap it up. And I'll see you tomorrow, probably. I don't know. I'm just taping every day of my life. For the rest of my life, I guess. Well, I'm going to link everything down below that I talked about. Again, hope y'all enjoyed. And subscribe to the channel if you're new.
It's only because I care about you. Wipe those tears from your face. They say the truth will set you free. Baby, I'll be your slave. It's only because I care about you. Put a smile on your face. Say the truth will set you free. I'll be your slave because I'm a liar, a cheater, a devil in disguise.